Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank God for being here. Thank God for being great. Amen. I thank God. Hallelujah. Somebody give him praise. Hallelujah. Somebody give him praise. Somebody give him praise. I've learned how to live holy. I've learned how to live right. I've learned. Well, I learned how to live holy. Hallelujah. I've learned how to live right. Eternal life. Can I get a witness over the airwaves? Hallelujah. I'm just telling you, just your voice is telling me. When I see Jesus, amen. When I see Jesus, amen. All of my troubles, they will all be over. When I see Jesus, amen. Hallelujah. 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 Thank God. Thank God. Amen. For being good. Thank God for allowing me to be here just one more Sunday morning. Amen. I hope, amen, this morning I catch you in the place where God have allowed you to be. We bring you greetings from Greater Light Ministry. I'm Elder Aaron Dykus, and I greet you this morning in the matchless name of Jesus. Amen. I thank you for taking time out of your schedule to join me over these airwaves, whether it be on Facebook or YouTube. Amen. We thank God for allowing us, amen, to be able to bring the word of God this morning. We want God, amen, to stop by here in a special way. Amen. God has been good to me. What about you? If he's been good, come on, just give him a little wave offering. Amen. Wherever you are this morning. Amen. We thank God for allowing our wife, amen, to be in our presence today. Amen. We most of all thank God for stopping by and touching us. Amen. In a mighty way. And so we won't hesitate. We're going to go right into the word of God. Amen. And if you have a Bible today, the word of God will be read. Amen. And we will, amen, read chapter and verse, or chapter and verses, Bishop Swasey would say. Amen. So we're going to give you what God has given to us, and we're going to ask God to bless this morning. Amen. I know somebody is praying for me because I feel the prayer wheels burning. Amen. I feel, amen, God is about to do something. He's about to do something miraculous and spectacular. Amen. In, amen, your spirit. Amen. I'm not talking about your life, because your life may seem like a wreck right now, but I'm here to let you know that God is still in control of every situation, and he will not let you down. So, amen, I want to read the word of God today. The word of God coming from Romans chapter number 8 and verse number 15. For the Bible says, we have not received the spirit of bondage again unto fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we call our Abba Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, and heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that you suffer with him, that you may also be glorified together with him. Amen. And my message today, amen, is we may suffer. We may suffer, but we will never lose hope. And I don't know about you, but I'm going to speak for me. I may suffer some things, but I'm never going to lose hope. Amen. The Bible goes on to say here, it says, for I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Somebody point to yourself and say, in us. Amen. So it goes on to say, for the creation was made subject to the vitality, not willingly, but by reason of him who have subject the same in hope. Amen. Because of the creation itself also shall be delivered unto the bondage of corruption, unto the glorious liberty of the children, amen, of God. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. And not only they, amen, but we ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even ourselves grown within ourselves, waiting for the adoption to it, amen, the adoption of our body. For we are saved by hope, hallelujah. But hope that is seen is not hope. For why, amen, hope for something that he see? Amen, it says, but if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. Amen, the Bible says, likewise, amen, the Spirit helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And my message, amen, today, amen, that we may suffer, amen, but that's all right. We will never lose hope. Amen. The Bible said the whole creation, amen, is groaning and travailing in pain. Amen. If I could get anybody to be honest right now, we see that our world, amen, is turned upside down. We see that there are so many things going on in the world that we cannot, amen, hardly catch our breath. When one thing happens, amen, something else will happen. Amen. I'm here to let you know that don't lose faith, because God is still in control of every situation. The Bible says, I reckon that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared, amen, to the glory to come. I don't know about you, but I love it, amen. We had the privilege to be under the leadership of Bishop Swansea, amen, for 25 years. And at times it almost seemed that the man was suicidal, amen, because he wanted to go home so bad. Amen. He would always say, this ain't my home. And we know that the man lived good, amen, in this world. We know he had material things. He had no want for anything. Amen. But he still had a desire that he wanted to go home and be out of this body. Because he realized that out of this body is present with the Lord. See, you and I, amen, I have to grasp in my mind, we have purpose. We woke up this morning, so because you woke up this morning, you have a purpose in your life. God has something that he wants you to do. And I have to admit, I have to, amen, say that I don't know what the purpose is for me. Amen. I've been searching and asking the God, what do you want me to do? I'm kind of lost. Amen. What should I do? But one thing I know for sure, that God won't never let me down. One thing I know for sure, that he will always be right by my side. And I want you to know out there over the airways that God, amen, is still working a purpose in your life. The Bible says that all things work together for the good to those who love the Lord, to those who are called according to his purpose. I wish I could get somebody to touch yourself and say purpose. God got purpose in your life. I had to realize, amen, that in the midst of this pandemic, I don't understand, amen, what's going on, but I understand that many people are suffering. You're suffering mentally and you're suffering physically. Amen. People are suffering from financial loss. People are losing their jobs, and that's just suffering everywhere you look. But I want you to know to be encouraged. Amen. Because even though you're suffering, don't lose hope. Amen. We look, amen, at our church situations. And I have to hit this because we don't know. We don't have a building where we can go together and that we can lift one another up. The one thing I do know, that your body is the temple of the living God. You can't let, amen, your circumstances or your situation turn you around from serving the true and living God. I'm here to let you know your life means something to God. God got something that he wants you to do, and you should pray, amen, to the Lord and ask him, what do you want me to do? I prayed to the Lord and he let me know that the Holy Spirit is making intercession for me. I don't know what to pray. I don't know what to pray. We see the situations. And let me tell you something. I want to go back and sit in the restaurants and go on vacation. I want to do all of those things. I do want to do those things. I want to be able to get on a plane safely, not worried about catching some kind of virus. I want to go in the congregation of the righteous. Yes. Amen. And lift up my voice and give God praise. I do want those things, God. I do. But I don't know what your will is. So I say your will be done. Yes. Whatever you have in for store for me, let me say yes to your will and not lose a hold of hope. I don't want you to lose a hold of hope. Even though we may not be able to do those things, we may not be able to never come together again, but one thing I know, I got hope that one day there will be a meeting in the promised land. One day we will get together, and what a time. Oh Lord, I'm here to let you know and to make you understand that whatever you're going through, just lift up your hands to the Lord and let him work it out. Let me go on here. Let me read here in 1 Timothy 4:10. It says, therefore, be sober. Amen. It says, therefore, we both labor and suffer reproach because we trust in the living God. Amen. Who is the salvation of all men, the Savior of all men, especially of those that believe. These things command and teach. I'm here to let you know that we're serving the true and living God. And I want you to know that God is still in control. Amen. We see that in our government, men are searching for a way to get out of this pandemic. They think the answer is, amen, in a serum that they put in your arm. And then we see that we change your leaders. People are looking for an answer. Amen. In the change of leadership. Amen. And the leaders are searching for answers. But I want you to know, because we serve the true and living God. Amen. The answer ain't in. Amen. Joe Biden. The answer ain't in. The governor of this state. The answer ain't in your local congregation. But God is the answer. He said, I am the way. I am the truth. Yes. And I am the life. Hey, hallelujah. God, I want you to know he didn't sit around and think, amen, my plan is failing, so I'm going to have to go to plan B. God got one plan. Yes. It's going to work. Yes. I don't know how it's going to work. I don't see it. I don't understand it. But one thing I know, that everything is in his hand, and he's going to work it out for your purpose. So don't lose hope. I wish I could get somebody to wave at your life and give God a praise and tell the Lord thank you. Amen. For being good in your life. Amen. So then we see Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter number 10 and verse number 13. It says, there has no temptation taken you that such is common to man, but God is faithful, who will not suffer you, amen, to be tempted above that you are able, but will with the temptation make a way of escape that you may be able to bear it. I don't know. I must say I don't understand what we're going through, but one thing I know, there's no temptation that God have put me through that he won't make a way of escape. There's nothing that God can't deliver you out of. You may be suffering, amen, from a disease that the doctor told you there was no healing, but that's all right. You see, amen, to live is Christ, but if you die, you got gain. I'm not looking for solution in the worldly situation, but I got a home up there in glory, and ain't that good news? I want you to know you got a home in glory, and you better tell God thank you for everything that I gotta suffer, because if I don't suffer, I can't reign. I've learned how to live holy. God, teach me how to live holy. Teach me how to walk. Teach me how to talk. Teach me how to do the things that please you. Because I'm not looking to my understanding, but I'm looking on you. For you're the one who is there. Somebody clap those hands and give God a praise. We see here, amen, many times, amen, it seemed like, amen, our pastor, he just wanted to go home. He said, I'm tired of this. I don't need another shirt. I don't need another coat. I just want to go home. Amen. And God granted him, amen, his request to go home. But you and I are still left here to suffer. Amen. God, taking the spiritual training wheels off of me and you. We don't have a church to go to, and we don't have a pastor. But I'm telling you, don't lose hope, because God is still on the throne, and he won't let you down. All you got to do is cast all of your cares upon him, because he's the one that cared for you. He cared for you more than you care for yourself. So I'm telling you, lift up your head, oh ye gates, and let the King of Glory take over. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. If you love the Lord, if you're determined to walk with him, don't let nothing turn you around. Don't let nothing make you give up your hope. Keep your hope. Your hope is in God. Your hope is in God. Somebody give him praise right there. So then, in Philippians, amen, chapter number 4, it says, I know both Paul talking here. Amen. We see Paul have a great testimony, and I don't know about you, suffered more than anybody, but he said here, he said, I know, amen, I know both how to abase, and I know how to abound, even everywhere in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things. Apostle Paul said, through Christ that gives me strength. I want you to know today that whatever you're going through, you can get through that trial. Whatever you're going through, you can do all things through Jesus Christ who gives you strength. God is the source of my strength. He's the one that brought me out. He's the one that saved me. He's not going to take us somewhere that he can't deliver us from. He's not going to go to plan B because plan A didn't work. God knows what he's doing. And all you got to do is keep on hoping in God. Hope unto the end. My hope is steadfast. I dare not hope in nothing else than Jesus Christ in righteousness. Oh Lord, my hope is built on Jesus. If your hope is built on Jesus, just give him a little wave over that way. And tell the Lord, thank you. Tell the Lord, thank you. Tell the Lord, thank you. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. Tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you for every mountain. Thank you for every valley. Thank you for every trial that I have to go through. Because if I never had a problem, I wouldn't know what faith in my God can do. But through it all, I learned to trust in Jesus. I learned to trust in God. And I won't give up. I don't have a look back spirit, but I believe everything is going to be all right. Somebody clap those hands. Give God a praise and tell the Lord thank you. Amen. We wrap it up here. Amen. The book. Amen. 1 Peter chapter number 3. Amen. Chapter number 3. 1 Peter and verse number 14. It says, but if any of ye suffer for righteousness, amen, sake, happy are ye. Be not, amen, afraid of the terrors, neither by the tribulations. Amen, if you suffer for righteousness' sake, you don't have to worry, because God is in control of every situation. I'm here to encourage you. God got purpose in your life, and all you got to do is wait for your change to come. Amen. Job, after he went through what he went through, he said, on my appointed time, I'm going to wait for my change to come. A change is coming your way, but hold on a little longer. And while you're holding on, give God praise. He said, in everything, you ought to give thanks. Amen. In everything, you ought to give thanks, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. The name of the Lord is to be praised. I don't know about you, but I'm going to praise him in the good times. I'm going to praise him in the bad times. I'm going to praise him when I'm
reason what I'm saying. I got a feeling that God's going to bring you out. And he's going to bring you out right on time. Somebody wave at your device and give God a praise and tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
Hey. And so then it goes on to say, amen, in verse number 17, in verse 18, for there is better if there will be, amen, it says, let me go again, for if it is better if there the will of God be so that you suffer the will doing not doing evil. Amen. God don't want you, amen, to suffer for evil. And it goes on, amen, to tell here, it said Christ also once suffered for the sins of the just and for the unjust, that he might bring into God and the things put to death in the flesh, amen, and quicken by the Spirit. Amen. God, I want you to know that he brought all things to himself. When you were dead and trespassed in sin, God still loved you. Amen. When you didn't know how to get out, God still loved you. I'm here to let you know you can cast all of your cares upon the Lord, because he's the only one who cares for you. I'm here to let you know and to make you understand that when you're in trouble, all you got to do is call on the name of the Lord. But they that called on the name of the Lord, you shall be saved, you shall be delivered, you shall be set free. So count it all joy. Amen. Don't wait till the battle's over. Begin to shout right now, because victory is nigh, even in your mouth. So I want you to know that God's been good. If he's been good to anybody, wave at your device and tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for every pain. Thank you for every heartache. Thank you for tribulation. Thank you for bringing me through. I don't know about you, but I'm running trying to make 100, because 99 and a half, it just won't do. I got a made up mind. I got a made up mind. And I know the outcome, it's going to be all right. So say yes. So say yes. Feeling that if you trust in God, if you hope until the end, then he's gonna bring you out. He ain't gonna leave you out there all by yourself. He ain't gonna let you, amen, be out there all by yourself. But God's gonna bring you out, and all you gotta do is trust in him. All you gotta do is believe in him, because everything, every little thing, every big thing, everything in between, it's gonna be all right. Come on and give him a wave offering. Come on and give him a wave offering. Amen. I'm winding up here. I'm winding up here. I know God, amen, is pleased with somebody this morning. Amen. Because you may have woke up in a depressive state. But God, amen, is letting you know that everything is going to be all right. So don't worry about it. Begin to shout victory. Begin to give God praise. Begin to tell God thank you. For he alone is worthy of all the praise. So say yeah. So say yeah. So say yeah. Yeah, yeah. So it goes on to say, amen. In my conclusion here, amen. Amen. In 2 Peter, amen. 1 Peter, chapter number 4. Amen. It says, if any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. That he may minister. Let him do it, amen, as the ability which God giveth, that God in all things may be glorified, amen, through Jesus Christ, to whom be praise, dominion forever and ever, amen. It says, beloved, think it not strange concerning the trials, which is to try you, if some strange thing happen unto you. I'm here to let you know, ain't nothing strange going on. God got everything in control, and you can count it all joy. God's going to bring you out. God's going to let you smile. There's a bright side somewhere. He'll turn your morning into in the left. He'll bring out, amen, something in you that you don't even know is in you. He'll let you smile again. And all you got to do is wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. And he's going to strengthen your heart. I need strength right now. I need you to let somebody know that they got purpose. Don't stand. God's going to do it. 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 Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. I wish I could get somebody to just give God a little praise. I wish I could get somebody to lift up the name of Jesus. But he alone is worthy of all your praise. Don't faint. Don't get in. Don't get out. But be encouraged and wait on the Lord. And while you're waiting, shout it out. For he's worthy. Somebody say yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody say yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody say yeah. I don't know what you got to go through. I don't know what you've been through. But one thing I know is my hope is in the Lord today. I take time to give God praise. Take time to glorify your God. He's worthy to be glorified. He's worthy to be lifted up.
Yeah.
Oh, he's good. To get glory. Oh,
yeah.
It is good to get praise. Oh, it's wonderful when I think of the goodness of Jesus. Oh, he's done for me.
Yeah.
My soul, my soul, my soul.
Oh,
hallelujah. I gotta praise him. I gotta praise him. I gotta praise him. Yeah. Somebody, wherever you at, whatever your situation is, tell the devil, you can't stop my praise. My praise, amen, is to God. My praise is to God. And Jesus, the author, know where I came from. Jesus, the finisher, know where I'm going. Jesus, my redeemer, so let the redeemed of the Lord say so. God redeemed you. So say yes.
So
say yes.
Yeah.
Somebody give him a break this way and begin to give him praise. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Ow.
Hey, glory.
Ow. I feel like it. I feel like it. I feel like it. Telling somebody, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Devil thought he had you all in a corner. And he ain't got you in no corner. Come on, fight it. Come on, fight it. For the victory is already won. The victory is already won. And the victory is in change. He, yes, and you ask, Jesus got all power. Jesus, all glory. Jesus, the author. Jesus, the finisher. Jesus, the first. Jesus, the last. Jesus, the author. Jesus, the maker. Jesus, the beginning. Jesus, the end. Know where you at. Tell me where I'm at. Teach me where I'm at. Take everything that's not like you. Because I got a hope. And my hope is in you.
Yeah.
your praise. This victory is your praise.
Yes.
Hey, I love you.
Hallelujah.
I thank you. That's all my time. Thanks for your time. And maybe somebody out there. Maybe somebody out there don't know. Amen.
God, for yourself.
I'm here to let you know. The church doors of your local assembly may be shut, but God is never shut. He never sleeps and he never slumbers. He's right there. He's just one call away. All you got to do is call the Lord. Amen. He'll answer. I'm here to let you know. Peter said, be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sin. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. This Holy Ghost is real. And if you don't know, you better ask somebody, because he's worthy of all of your praise. Go ahead and take it out with a praise.
Hallelujah.